So once again, ladies and gents, this is bout number 14 of this evening's show. Sponsored by Fight and Talk, this is a title bout, an amateur featherweight champion fight. 5 3-minute rounds were scheduled for. Introducing your fighters, first of all, in the blue corner. Age 21, he stands at 5'11" tall. He's an MMA record of 6 wins, 2 losses and no draws. He's from Bristol, representing Reed MMA. He weighed in at 65.8 kilograms. Please put your hands together for Ryan Southern! Facing him across the cage at his opponent in the red corner. Age 22, he stands at 5'7" tall. He's a record of 3 wins, no losses and no draws. He's from Newcastle, representing MTK Newcastle. He weighed in at 65.7 kilograms. Please put your hands together for Daniel Cranston. Once again, this is a title bout. We're scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds. Your referees, Phil De Vries. The action is about to begin.
And here we go. Tail of the tape here. 3-0, the perfect record of Dan Cranston. 6-2, apologies, for Ryan Southern.
One thing to look out for with Dan Cranston is his leg kicks. I believe he's got a couple of stoppages by leg kicks already. But big step up in competition for him tonight.
Plenty feints from Cranston, from both my nearly doors. I love seeing that as well, Cranston, almost like Israel Adesanya type hip feint.
Yeah, he likes to show the hip.
Nice,
he's already hit that calf a couple of times.
Very interesting movement from Cranston here.
Ryan Southern definitely looks like the bigger man in there.
He certainly does, but that doesn't look like it's phasing Cranston at all. Plenty stance switching. I'm not aware, but I feel like Cranston may have experience in his striking discipline. His movement just seems very fluid.
It very much looks like he has. Very composed in there. Gives a little feint there, the old Sean O'Malley feint, looks behind him and throws forward.
And this is what you want, though. You want this confidence in such a big fight like this.
100%, especially when you're taking on a more experienced opponent.
Such tight guard from both men. That leg kick, like you said there, he's got a couple of stops just by leg kicking. We can already see the rending on the leg of Southern.
Yes.
And you've got to think those stoppages have came within 9 minutes. Of course, he's got 15 here to work.
Yeah, I like how Cranston's attacking the outside and the inside leg.
We've got a very animated Nad Narimani in the corner of Ryan Southern.
Yeah, very animated there. Must want more from his man.
Been a very technical back on his feet. That banging you can hear is Nad, of course, banging on the side of the cage, getting told by our cage side official. Nice. Very, very technical fight this one, as we expected. Nice right hand though from Southern.
Yeah, it looks like Southern's happy to strike with Cranston. He's just wobbled after that leg kick though.
Oh, that looked low. It was accidental, of course, but the second that fired in, I think Cranston knew himself it was low.
Yeah, it's one of those, when you throw that inside leg kick, it can come a little bit high. Cranston's squinting a little bit. I noticed it when they were calling his name as well. I can't help but wonder if he's got like eye contacts in.
Lovely takedown, mixing things up now.
Yeah, change of pace here from Cranston, change of strategy. Keeping Southern guessing, very smart. I think he probably took the round there.
Seconds out here as we go into our second of 5 rounds, should we need them. Cranston just checking his nose there as well. I don't know if he's been caught with something. And
bit of blood on his foot. I'm not sure what that's from.
I wonder if it's even a small cut on his foot
itself,
throwing them kicks. And could that deter you?
It'll be sore, but I don't think it's going to stop him. It's definitely his main game plan. He knows he's got his guy hurt there. He's kind of taunting his opponent there.
Spinning side kick from Cranston, trying to mix things up a little bit.
Southern manages to avoid the leg kick there.
You can see though the rending around just below the knee. It's right round Southern's leg as well if you have a look. Just that left leg is wrapping its way right round. Of course, them calf kicks again, something that was so underutilised for so many years, and now we've seen a few big title fights change the course of a few big title fights. Now everybody seems to be doing them.
Yeah, for sure. It's definitely harder to block than your standard leg kick.
Big shots from both men there. Southern 8-1, then give two back of his own.
Oh, nice switch through to the left high kick there by Cranston.
Lovely fancy work here from Cranston. He's wanting to try and win this title in style.
Yeah, he's really putting on a show here.
He's getting caught every now and again, but he never seems fazed by it.
Yeah, Southern likes to come forward with that double jab right hand. He's had a bit of success with that.
Pressed up now against the cage. Worst position, I think. Cranston's probably found himself in.
Yeah, good head position from Southern. Yeah, he's just chipping away. Oh, beautiful job by Cranston, though, to get off the cage.
Nice work there again from both Southern and Cranston. Unlike our last fight, this one seems to be a lot more to and fro-ing.
Yeah, for sure.
What would you like to... happy with what both men are doing, or would you like to see something different if you were in either man's corner?
I think it's... I'd like to see Cranston keep firing away with that calf kick. I think he's going to have success with that. As I say, he does that. Southern's putting on a bit of a brave face as he's plodding forward, but I think he's always coming second when they're both punching, exchanging punches. I'd like to see Southern test out the ground game of Cranston and go for a takedown.
And as we see, of course, them calf kicks, it's money in the bank, isn't it? Especially over five rounds.
For sure.
Nice stiff jab there.
His right hand over the top by Cranston.
And these rounds are very close. Yes, Cranston is on the front foot, but the rounds are very close.
Cranston again looking for a last minute takedown, to try and steal the round, just put a kind of stamp on it.
10 seconds to go here in this round. And another close round, but I think arguably another round that goes to Cranston.
Yeah, I would have to agree. It's looking like the busier man in there, as much as Southern's still in the fight. And it is close. I think Cranston's just kind of edging it with each round, landing the cleaner strikes.
Interesting to see there as well, just on what we picked up before. The blood on the foot of Cranston is coming from a cut that looks like it's just above his ankle, his heel, sorry, on the inside.
Yeah, that'll definitely be sore, particularly tomorrow. But as long as it's not a really, really deep gash, I don't think it's going to affect him here. And I think he's going to continue to keep chipping away at that leg.
Here we go, third round coming up of the five. Should we need them? And here we go. Paul Reed and Adnan Armani asking for more of the same from their man, Ryan Southern. Nice.
High kick attempt there, blocked.
The movement of Cranston looks like it'd be very, very hard to read.
Yeah, he's feinting very well, but he's also doing little level changes as well, which is keeping Southern guessing, considering he has actually shot for a couple of takedowns. Very, very smart tactics here used by Cranston.
Nice right hand through the middle, then a couple of punches followed up from Southern.
Yeah, Southern's definitely had a lot of success with his right hand. It's just been few and far between. If he throws it more, he seems to be finding a home for it.
Nice jab there from Southern as well. And again, Cranston though looking to go back to that lead leg.
I'm still surprised we've not seen Southern try to grapple here.
Big shot there, and again.
As I say that, he lands a nice couple of jabs.
Southern seems to be finding his rhythm a lot more here in this third round.
Yeah, he's setting it up nicely with the jab. If he put that right hand behind it, he's definitely going to have some more success.
Nice right hand there from Southern. He's definitely growing into this in this third round.
100%.
The gum shield's out.
Phil DeFries stops the action, gives them a chance to put it in.
Of course, that is on the referee's discretion, but happy to do so straight away.
Oh.
There, see the leg up there this time, yeah. Then the switch of stance from Southern.
Cranston needs more of that.
You wonder now, though, if them cork kicks are starting to pay dividends.
Cranston managed to anticipate the big right-hand counter there and avoid it, but he's just got caught with one.
Much more competitive round this one, and a much more round that Southern starting to look to try and really dominate.
Yeah, Southern throwing some nice shots now.
Nice right hand
there
again.
He's really found his range now.
Interesting to see the way the momentum shifted here. Another few big shots there from Southern. Nose bleeding now, and again. Very sharp striking from Ryan Southern. You wonder if Cranston, and again he gets tagged.
It's almost like he knew something we didn't, you know. He's been a little bit behind the first two rounds, but he's persisted with the striking, and now it's starting to pay off for him.
On the front foot now, Southern, for I'd say possibly the first time in this fight, really pushing on.
Dan Cranston's face starting to show a bit of damage.
And there we go, third of five rounds in. A big, big round for Ryan Southern.
Much better round. Perhaps a change of the tide there.
Like you say though, I wonder if he's been, yeah, maybe he knew something we didn't coming into this and knew that if he could see out them first two, rounds that the fight could be his to take over.
Yeah, for sure. Like he's clearly been confident in his stand-up, and now it's actually starting to show.
Well, this is what we want from a title fight, Joe, isn't it? We want these competitive, high-level matchups.
100%. You know, we're three rounds in, and this fight could still go either way.
Both men getting seen too here. Both men appear to have bloody noses. Nothing too much. Last words of advice here as we enter the championship rounds in this featherweight title fight. I feel like Nan Narimani's getting a workout here as well.
Oh, for sure. It's one of those when you've got a guy fighting, you're always going to be heavily invested, never mind when it's for a title.
Going straight away, Cranston looking for that leg kick. Interested to see how this round plays out. Of course, Southern then really starting to build into the fight in that third round. Popping out a stiff jab, catches Cranston, and again. Like you say, it just seems to be the distance and everything he just seems to have now. It was almost if he took them two rounds just to download all the intel he could take.
Yeah, yeah, making his reads. He's avoiding the leg kick now, which is a big thing. Oh, got caught there though.
Nice.
Really putting his hands together, nice.
Doubling up on that jab as well, coming forward. Now he's looking for the takedown of his own, and he gets it immediately. Could this be the tides turning?
He's got his back. Both hooks are in.
And this will be a big, big performance here, if Southern could get a choke. That looks close.
Oh, he might be under the net
it
there.
It looks like it's on the jaw. Is it possible? It's under the net. It looks tight.
Oh.
Cranston trying to fight the hands here.
I think he's got it. He's going palm to palm. This is definitely under the neck.
Of course, the bloody nose won't be helping with the breathing here either.
Oh, well done. Dan Cranston
but did
very well.
But he gets his back
there.
Taken in the process. And it looks like Southern's going to look for it again.
Cranston managed to just move his body at an angle where Southern couldn't quite get the leverage he needed.
The tide's really turned here, haven't they? The momentum's
sure,
totally
sure.
Different.
And you know, by Southern entertaining the striking battle so long, he really caught Cranston off guard with that takedown. And here he is again under the neck. I think
that
he's got
tight.
It. Yes.
And he gets the tap! Ryan Sullen taking the belt back to Bristol, back to Slepfer, back to Reed MMA. What a performance, a big upset here, but what a win for Ryan Sullen.
Huge, huge performance, especially given the first two rounds. He really had to dig deep there, you know, walk through the fire, and he ultimately, I believe it, he's shown his experience there.
Yeah,
he didn't blow his gas tank. He stayed in there, he walked Cranston down, he started to see him fade, and then he picked it up a gear. But you know, for Cranston, you know, this is his fourth fight, first defeat, and he's up there against a much more experienced opponent, so I'm sure he's took a lot from this fight as well. First title fight, I'm sure there'll be many more. But overall, great fight here by these two gentlemen.
Once again, ladies and gents, could you please put your hands together for both of our warriors inside the cage? Don't forget, this fight was for a vacant title, and we have a winner by way of referee stoppage, rear naked choke in the very last round. And your winner in the blue corner, Ryan Sullen! Also, your runner-up, Daniel Cranston.